What's going on, everybody? It's Crazy Man here, back bringing you guys a commentary today and sort of an update video as well. This is a 1v1 on the map Legus or Legius High Stadium, however you want to say it, Legus or Legius. I prefer Legius just because, you know, you have to overemphasize everything. Ooh, that's a big word. But this video is not so much about the gameplay as it is, well, I guess it is actually about the gameplay, but it's more or less talking about the Retribution tournament, the 2v2 tournament I was planning on holding today. That's not going to happen, at least for another couple months. I know there are a lot of people that are going to be disappointed with that, but I have a lot of stuff going on right now. Number one, I'm sick, in case you can't hear the runny nose, or, you know, my voice is kind of like, yeah, you know, whatever. Voice is a little down. So there's that. Number two, I have school starting Tuesday. So, you know, I have to be very wary of that, because summer's been good, but I probably should have had this tournament earlier in the summer, but it never really came to me. And, oh, I have like four, actually, I think. Number three, there's not enough people. There's three teams. And it's hard to run these bigger tournaments with 2v2s. Like 2v2s as opposed to 1v1s, because six players, you kidding me? There you go. 2-2-2. And then that branches off into, you know, who had the most convincing victory. They would probably get a bye or whatever. And then we'd have the next two players play, but whatever. And then we would have those guys play in the finals. But with a... excuse me, with a... what's this nade? Boop! But with this, that's just three teams. And with 3v3s, I will probably never hold a 3v3 tournament, just because of the madness that is getting even four teams together. That's 12 players. That's like half the Retribution community right there. I mean, my god. That's insane. That was a joke. There's actually like 100 people online right now, but I actually got this match today. And number four, it's stressful. I mean, it is stressful to be... I found this out in the 1v1 tournament. I know people are going to be like, oh, you're just playing a game. You're just casting a game, whatever. It's not that. More or less the... you are living in Europe, and this guy is living all the way across the United States. So let's say, I know one. It was the finals matchup for the 1v1 tournament. Buddy Petros against Candyman. Candyman lives in California. That's 3 hours behind my time. So as of now, it would be about 9 a.m. there. Petros, who lives in Greece, I believe he's 6 or 7 hours ahead of me. I don't know. It's 6 or 7 hours. One of the two. That's a 9-hour difference. That's a big difference. I mean, that's hard to just be like, oh yeah, we're both ready to go. And there's that thing. I didn't even expect that. I didn't even think about that in the first time. And with these bigger tournaments and having to get more players, that becomes equally more complicated, because you have more people from different time zones. I think I had one guy from Australia who said he wanted to play, and it's like, dude, I don't know the Australian time thing. Isn't that like 12 hours difference? Right now it'd be like midnight there. He'd be asleep. He'd be asleep every time I'm awake. Well, maybe not that. Like, I'm awake at midnight, but, you know, I probably wouldn't be casting anything at midnight, I can guarantee you that. But that's the situation with that. I know it's going to sound like, oh, he's squinting and complaining. Dude, it's just a lot of work for not a lot of gain, to be perfectly honest. I mean, you guys get to watch some good games, yeah. I get to watch some good games, yeah. But it's not like we're watching, you know, a bunch of hot, super high-level games. I mean, yeah, there are pretty good games, but it's not like we're watching pros just, like, punch each other in the face with god units and stuff. I mean, this is all stuff you've seen before. And yeah, so that's just a case with that. Tournament postponed indefinitely. Until I really get a freaking break where I'm not... Thursday night, excuse me, tonight's Friday night. Last night I had a football game to go to, so I couldn't have started it then. And this whole week I had to go to football practice. And it's like, it's super busy, and it's a bad time for me to hold the tournament. The reason I wanted to hold the tournament was because Petros asked for another tournament. And, you know, I wanted to be a good friend, but there comes a point when it's like, okay, I need to kind of think about myself here before going ahead and shooting a gun saying we can hold the tournament and do all this crazy stuff, because we can't. Or I can't. But that's the case with that. And now back to the game. Now we're talking about the game. Why is this game so special? Not because I'm just landing nades left and right. Because this player I'm up against, this AlexoV077, is actually the 33rd best player in the world for 1v1s. That's pretty damn impressive. I don't care who you are. This may be the highest guy I've played against. I know this is the highest guy I've played against in 1v1s, and here I fail with a nade. I start failing with nades, actually. I actually hit that guy. So it didn't, wasn't a total fail. Just didn't kill him. But, yeah. So this is a pretty high-level game. However, it took me 5 minutes to get in the game. So after this game, I'm kind of hoping... Spoiler! As you can see, I'm already winning, so I think I'm winning the... Oh, I'm not winning the tech battle. Wow. But you can pretty much see I'm winning the resource battle, and you can see where the game is going. Hopefully, the matchmaking system is like, do we put this 2,000 skill guy against this 6,000 skill player? Hopefully, it says yes from now on, because I'm up for some challenge, and this was a fun challenge, except for the fact that it was laggy. Very, very laggy. And over here, he's trying to micros force his way. Oh, but he forgot about Das Sentinel, and down it goes. Sorry, I'm looking over at my other computer. My old computer. I actually have that on today because I'm going to download some music. Because music is good. He's actually got a manicore. Now, this is an interesting choice. This is a choice I would not recommend anyone do in 1v1s unless you are up against Space Marines, Tactical Space Marines, specifically, actually, Tactical Space Marines, or Chaos Space Marines. And Chaos Space Marines with Heretics as grenade launchers, you know, even Tyranids if they go that heavy ranged build like I like to do. But just getting one of these in a 1v1 in general, it's not a good idea. And there's another fail nade. Man, I'm catching all the nades today, unfortunately. Just getting a Manticore in 1v1 in general, in my opinion, not a good idea. Because, I mean, you're going to see that he lands a bunch of Manticore strikes that are really solid. He lands one right on these guys in like half a second. And there he goes. I saw the red dot. I actually just moved my screen away. Lands a really solid strike. Does a ton of damage. Almost kills them. But it doesn't. It doesn't kill them. They walk away just fine. Sure, that's going to cost me a bunch of requisition to reinforce. But does it really look like requisition is a problem for me? I mean, I'm sitting on like 500 already. Well, at this point, I should be wasting it all away on Banshees or something, but he does the correct build here in the sense that he hits Ogryns. He probably should also get Flamers or Flamer and Plasma Gun, simply because I have Light Infantry. I do believe Banshees are classified as Light Infantry. Here, if you're wondering why I didn't throw a grenade, it's on cooldown. Fucking thing. Sorry about the language, but that pissed me off. It like had like 1 second of cooldown, and it was like, are you serious? Like, it was like... I can't even make the reference of how close it was to being uncooldowned. Off cooldown. That off cooldown sounds lame. But yeah. Starting to pimp out my commander. The reason I get this entangling web, this can be very, very good with in combination with the nades. Because what he likes to do is he likes to move his guardsmen around, as you've seen. Well, entangling web them, they can't move. They're dead. Here, look at that. That the Wraith Lord just tanking it like a boss. Actually landing that grenade there as well. So I believe I've landed 3 nades to 2 misses, which is a pretty damn good ratio. And here, oh, come on, man. 25 HP. Actually, he throws down a heavy turret as well. That's expensive. That's a big investment for him. Fortunately for him, spoiler, in like half a second, it ends up paying off. He does kill off this Wraith Lord. I mean, anyone who has a fairly high IQ about this game will know that, I mean, he's going to take this thing out. Look at the range on it. That's what I'm amazed by. The range on this thing is incredibly high, and it is doing a lot of damage. But not before my Banshees do a lot of damage to the Ogryns, which is good. I love the fact that Banshees are almost they're a very good counter to Ogryns, and a lot of people would not think that. But just watch later in the game. I end up building another Banshee squad, and the two Banshees, obviously fully upgraded, obviously they cost more, but for the most part, they hold their own against Ogryns pretty well. And here you're going to see my commander taking out Generatus. Ba 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 ba. That's the noises I was making in game 2. I probably should have actually hopped in this building. But I didn't. And again, another Manticore strike. They still walk away. Wouldn't that be hilarious if that was the same squad and the same guy who just walked away from the first Manticore strike? He watches like his whole squad just gets obliterated the first time, and then he like gets a whole new squad and they get obliterated again, and he's the only survivor. Man, that man would deserve a war medal. And I'd give him a war cookie. I don't care if he gets fat. He's earned it. He's the Manticore survivor. This is what I love about the Warp Spider Exarch. I mean, his mobility. And it's mobility in a game where the pathing is very unpredictable, so it's your mobility. The pathing cannot screw me over when this guy's in teleport range of, like, here. If he can teleport to there, or he can teleport back, the pathing's not going to be like, oh, he's going to take the long way to teleport. No, there is no long way to teleport. He's there to there. But I see the Ogryns. I actually don't know what I do with these guys. I'll talk to that guy in a second. He was actually in the tournament. I don't actually know what I do with these guys, because this is a difficult situation. I want to go over here and cap this point, and I land another nade up there. I don't think that nade is very good, though. Didn't do a lot of damage. But, because if I move this way, turret's going to fucking... that's going to destroy me, man. So here we go. He's obviously in the middle of capping that point, so I suppress. He does his little charge knockback thing. He's still suppressed while that. I thought that actually broke suppression. Apparently it doesn't. And then I use my other squad to suppress. Here comes his Manticore strikes. Pretty much landing on that little ridge right there. I'm not sure if that actually affected the outcome of the battle or not. Maybe it did for him. I don't know. Maybe I could have stayed. Maybe. I didn't want to risk it. Because I know Banshees are really light armored. And they take a lot of damage. Oh, and he also shoots a Manticore. Oh no, he drops this full-on support power right here, which made me laugh, because I probably actually could have just not retreated right there and been perfectly fine. Either way, I'm trying to run over here and nade him, and these guys are super late, and I throw the nade and it misses. And they mad. They are really mad, and here comes the swarm of guardsmen. Hopping in this building. I don't even know why there's structures out here, actually. If there's one thing that Relic is fairly good at, it's putting useless things on the map that you would never think to use, but actually do. I don't know if that was the Survivor Guardian squad or not, but they all got eliminated right there. I think that may have been. Either way, he's got his Commissar General dude. Which, I don't know why it doesn't actually have the thing on him. He's got his little helmet thing rocking. Oh, called in my, I called in my Alatark. That was the highlight of my game. I actually missed that. I never use these damn things, but I just wanted to use it just because of the splash damage from the cooldown. Because the Caldon just does so much damage. I mean, it did all the damage you see these guys have taken. He actually shoots the... Can he hit me? I don't know. I wasn't actually even paying attention. If he can hit me down that or not. Over here, the Banshees fighting the Ogryns. Notice I use the fleet of foot to get away. Oh, shit. Notice I use the fleet of foot to get away, then I retreat. That's how you want to escape from melee units. You want to use any ability you can, especially with the Eldar. Want to use their thing to get away, their fleet of foot generally, to get away. And here the Ogryns are in trouble. And they are going to take a lot of damage. And, I mean, it's not like I built anything spectacular. Oh, I actually kill him. I wasn't even paying attention there. That's when he concedes him. What is going on here? Good God. He's spraying spider webs at them. Yeah, that's the game against the 33rd best player in the world. For those of you who do not believe me, I will show you right now. There you can see AlexOV077. Maybe he's fallen a little bit. There's all my replays. And here we go. There's Warp. There he is, right there. AlexOV077. With 1,000 wins. He's packing. But that's the game, guys. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to click that like button. Sorry about the tournament. Again. The timing just is not right for it. Maybe another day. Maybe another weekend. Maybe another time. I don't know. But definitely not going to be this weekend. Just too much going on next week for me, really. And, yeah. That's pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed. And I'm out. See ya.